The works came in all shapes and sizes, took in dozens of techniques and styles, and had titles ranging from the intriguing Champagne and Peeling Walls to the prosaic Whitechapel Bell Foundry, and all inspired by a competition designed to conjure up the spirit of London. As it turned out, though, the overall winner was of an orchard in Devon.
Don't you think some artists who've gone out of their way to paint parts of London to try and conjure up the real spirit of London might be a little bit miffed that the painting that's won is a very good painting, but a painting of Devon?
If you think of the top GLC Jobs Award painting, it could have nothing to do with anything but London.
So it was a question of good painting rather than the subject matter?
Indeed, it always would be in the final analysis.
I put in three. You can submit three for this exhibition, and two of them were paintings of London, and this one wasn't.
And it won.
That's right.
You must be pleased about that.
I'm delighted, yes.
GLC Arts Chairman Peter Pitt revealed that post-GLC, it's likely the competition will live on through the Arts Council. Tory Party Deputy Chairman Geoffrey Archer, sponsor of the Young Artists Prize, says he'd be sorry to see the contest go.
But not so sorry to see the GLC go.
Oh no, I think the GLC was long due for overgoing, and if the things can be shunted off at different levels, that's a very good thing. And I hope this will be a classic example of something that can continue.
The winning paintings and the best of the rest will be on display at the Royal Festival Hall until March 2nd. Paul Arsman, Thames News.